So I was gonna do a more complicated pose today, but I think I'm gonna not do that. It's kind of gonna show the idea of movement, and I was gonna do this pose, but it's pretty complicated because Sonic's looking this way, his body's looking that way. So if you want to challenge yourself, I'm gonna go over some basic principles, and you can draw this one. Like maybe Gabe, you want to take a shot at this one? You feel like you can do it? Do it. Otherwise, I'm gonna do actually just kind of a standard Sonic pose. So I'm gonna be doing something like this. This Sonic is actually the original artwork for the Japanese Sonic 3. Japanese Sonic, weirdly enough, looks different than American Sonic. This is American Sonic. I know that you guys don't care, but I'm burning time, and then I'll start drawing. American Sonic originally had one row of quills. This is things you've learned. And he had a circle head, and you could see, one sec, Finn, and you could see the circle really clearly. Classic Japanese Sonic, you cannot see the circle. And he actually has, let's see, five. He has seven quills on the back of his head, so he's a little bit different. So we're gonna be doing just this classic Japanese style Sonic. Oh, other thing is that American Sonic also is supposed to look more like Felix the Cat or Mickey Mouse, which is why if you look at a picture of Mickey Mouse and you look at Sonic or Felix the Cat, they look identical, especially Felix the Cat. The gloves are also very Disney-esque, Mickey Mouse-esque. They have one role here. The Japanese one has more of a kind of two roles. So, anyway, that's just a bunch of nerd stuff about Sonic. Hi, Zeke. You should see if Ruby can get on if you could text Shanna. Okay, so let's go ahead and start this. Hopefully you guys can see well. If I go too fast, just let me know. I can see all your comments and stuff.
I'm still coloring mine.
Move the pictures to your left so that we can see it. You mean these pictures over here? So we're gonna be doing this one. And if you want to actually look, I mean, I can't really zoom in. I can't mess with this too much. But if you search Sonic Official Art into Google, this thing pops up. I don't know if you can open up a separate window. And this is from Sonic the Hedgehog 3 in Japan, so hope that works. Okay, let's go ahead and start. So last week we talked about, and Finn, this is where you can kind of listen in too. We talked about drawing very light pencil sketches initially. So we drew Toon Link. And the idea is that before you lay down any solid lines, you lay down some very rough sketches. So a good example of is something like this. I could erase any of these lines and get rid of the ones that I don't want. So our first stage here is we're going to focus on drawing very light lines. The second stage, we're going to focus on drawing very dark lines. Oh, I see what you're saying, Jenny. Yeah, I have a bunch of references, but these are the only ones that you're gonna need to really pay attention to. Awesome job, Finn. Finn's already drawn Sonic, so he's on it. So initially, big lesson here is draw very light lines. Ultimately, we'll ink it so you can see my pencil here, and then we'll erase the light lines. Oh no, this eraser is bad. Gosh. We'll erase these light lines and get rid of them, and then all that will be left is the ink. Okay, so that's the idea. If you have really little ones that you are drawing with, then just have them kind of follow along as close as they can to the drawing. But keep in mind, I'm going to be doing a lot of pencil lines that will not show up in the original drawing, like lines like this. These lines won't, this cross here won't show up. So, okay, let's go ahead and start. So, does anybody know the company that made Sonic the Hedgehog? Post in the comments. What company made Sonic the Hedgehog? So the first thing we do here, is just a very, just a circle. Just like Toon Link last week, Sonic is made up of some really basic shapes. And in fact, they're pretty similar. Just like Toon Link, the head is just a circle. And if you want to think of it as kind of more like a sphere, and again, draw these lines very lightly if you are drawing them. He just has a sphere for a head. The drawing, again, I'm doing is this one here. So his head is a little bit to the side, so I want to make sure I get these lines right. He's kind of tilting his head a little bit to the this way, to his left, I guess. And then, so he has a circle for a head. He has another circle for a body. So Toon Link had a cylinder, and Sonic has a circle for his body. It's just another sphere. This sphere. So I'm drawing these cross lines so you kind of get an idea of the 3D-ness of the shape. For those of you, maybe you don't need to go that far, you can kind of think of it as more of a, just a circle is fine. So, but I do this for me, so I can think of how light is going to hit it. I can think of, let me put this over a little bit so you can see it better. Let's see, it looks like the lighting is a little rough here. So, I think of how the light is going to hit the circles when I add lighting later. This is kind of just a print-off, but you can see on the original there's a big shadow that goes across his belly. And the reason they know how that shadow is going to look is because they know it's a sphere, right? So you have these two circles. This is what we're working with at first here. You can see these circles overlap. I don't think Sonic has a neck. Pretty sure. His head just kind of sits on top of this other circle. Then, just at first, you can draw just lines for his arm. So, he actually has a similar pose as last week. His arm is resting on his hip. I really need to get a better eraser than this. It's a bad eraser. And so you kind of just draw a sideways U, if you want to think of it that way. But then it kind of tips down. It's kind of aiming this direction, okay? And the idea is that his hand is going to be pressing into his hip here, okay? He's really putting a lot of weight on his hip with his hand. There's two shapes to Sonic's hand, basic shapes, then we'll add more complex shapes. The first one is like... it's like a thick bracelet, if you want to think of it that way. Maybe think of like a cup sort of shape. And this is actually his, the folds of his glove. How am I doing here? Does anybody have any questions or anything so far? Are we good? We're getting these basic shapes down. Again, it's very important you draw very lightly. We always want to draw super hard lines, and then that can, and then they're difficult to erase, right? And then I'm just actually going to do a circle, just a little circle here that overlaps his glove. And this is going to be his hand, ultimately. So basically his hand is pressed into this, this circle here. This circle is going to be touching the base of this circle, okay? Just to add some depth to this, basically his arm, he has super skinny arms. They're noodles, okay? So that's what makes Sonic fun to draw, is he's very, wiry. If you look at some of these drawings here, you can see it's easy to put Sonic into action poses because you basically have a basic shape and then his noodles are kind of coming off of this this main circle here, right? His noodle arms, his noodle legs. Those are the shapes. There's not a lot of muscular definition in Sonic. Or even this one. This is official art from Sonic Mania. You can see he just kind of has... Even in here, the artist just drew literally a circle for his hand. And then here you can see more fingers. So anyway, he's fun to draw in running and action poses, but we're just going to draw him standing still. Now, this arm, we didn't talk about this last week, but we're going to be doing what's called foreshortening. So this hand that I'm going to draw right here is going to look really, really big. And that's because it's super close to the viewer. Okay, so there's kind of a sense of depth. You can see his hand is close. If I have my hand here and I move it closer, it's going to be bigger, right? So that's what's happening with his hand here. So basically, if you want to do just a couple marks to get an idea of where things will land, the top of his thumb is going to be right below his head. His other finger is going to be right on the side of his head here. This is his pointer finger, okay? So you kind of have an idea, and then it's going to create a backwards kind of L shape. It's not exactly an L, but basically that's the shape. This is his thumb and his finger. And you can base the rest of his hand off of that. Hands are super complicated to draw. They're kind of their own little thing in themselves, so try your best here. And if you guys have questions about the hands, you can leave them in the comments there. He has kind of a bubble. If you want to think of the actual shape of the hand, you could do a circle here, and then kind of an oval shape here. And this would be, so you have this L coming off of the circle. And again, draw these super light. We're going to erase a lot of these lines later. And you can, and the whole point here is that you can erase stuff you don't like. Like, see, I feel like I don't want his thumb to be exact like that. And if it's not exact like the main drawing, don't worry about it. If you kind of get lost and you're like, oh, I'm really struggling with this hand, it looks weird, just start from scratch. Erase, try a different way of drawing it. Coming off to the side here is you have his middle finger. Middle finger is a little bit longer than this finger. Is a general rule of thumb. Ha ha ha. That's my dad joke of the day. Does anybody know who made Sonic? Nobody even put it in the comments. Are you guys just busy drawing? What game company made Sonic? Should be pretty, it's pretty standard. They're pretty popular back in the day for all you parents that are watching. These fingers are basically going to be like ovals, side-by-side ovals. They actually overlap, okay, just like that. Now, his fingers are closed, okay, so a really cool thing you can do is literally make it with your hand and draw your own hand. The only difference is that Sonic has kind of sausage fingers, okay, his fingers are going to be a lot bigger, because he's a cartoon character. See, and I'm changing some of these lines. I'm erasing lines I don't like, getting rid of them. You might make like a finger longer, like, ah, one looks weird. And hands do take a long time to draw. They're tricky to draw. Kind of just adding things. I'm actually looking at the image here and trying to copy it the best I can. Sega is right. Sega back in the day was almost the biggest video game company, second only to Nintendo. When the very first Nintendo came out, 1985, and they were the only video game console you could buy, for all you youngins. Today you can buy a Nintendo Switch, you can get a Sony PlayStation, an Xbox, you can get a computer. Back then you had a computer, but when it came to consoles, the only thing you could get was a Nintendo. Everything else didn't matter. There's other consoles, but they barely had games for them. And then Sega came along, challenging the juggernaut that was Nintendo. And they created the Sega Genesis, and their main mascot was Sonic the Hedgehog. And they ended up by 1993, so about 4 years later, they owned 50% of the market, and the Sega Genesis was the rival to the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. It was called the Great Console War. So, okay, I'm drew a couple things. This is the bottom of his glove. This shape is kind of an ovaly shape, if you think about it. His hand is technically coming out of this. And then this is his arm in the background here. This isn't another finger. So what's happening is he's sticking his finger towards the audience, right? So his arm is just coming straight in, and his arm would be behind his hand, so you couldn't really see it. Okay? That's kind of the idea here. Sonic on the front of his belly has a circle here. And you just kind of draw this circle on the front of the big circle. You leave a little gap here. And so now we're getting his basic shapes down. This head is going to overlap, so you could even erase this if you would like to. And you can kind of see Sonic coming to life here. Just like his arms, he has noodly legs also. So yeah, here's one leg, and here's another leg. So his legs just come out of the bottom of the circle here. This leg is behind on the back side of the circle. This one would be on the front part. His legs are just going to be going down. Again, just like his gloves, he has kind of a cup shape or like a big bracelet shape here. And so just at the bottom. Okay. So, I don't know what that looks like, but yeah, noodles going into a cup is the idea. So, and then his foot is, the basic shape is like a triangle, so I can even draw the triangle like this, but it's kind of rounded it's kind of a rounded shape there at the sides. Some artists actually draw, get this eraser fixed. Some artists actually draw, Sonic with more triangular, angular shoes. The original Sonic, though, it's kind of like a rounded triangle. And in fact, it's actually like a candy corn. It's the exact shape of a candy corn, if you want to think of his feet like a candy corn. So this would be the top of that candy corn. And then he has a little wrap, a white wrap that kind of comes around his shoe. Sometimes they'll put a buckle on there. Old Sonic drawings. Old Japanese Sonic drawings would have a buckle that would tie his thing. Japanese artists love having buckles on stuff. It's really weird. Hey, Mason, what's up? I see Mason just jumped in. Kelly, what's going on? We've kind of already started. If you guys kind of go back, maybe you could watch it or jump in. We're drawing this Sonic over here. Is the idea. What else about Sonic? Sonic taught me how to read as a child. When this game came out, Sonic 3, I think it came out when I was 7 years old, and they had video game magazines, which they still have today, but most stuff's online. But I had to go to the grocery store and sit at the magazine rack and read the video game magazines to see when the new Sonic was coming out, because I thought Sonic was the coolest thing ever as a kid for whatever reason. Here I'm doing another candy corn. This one's kind of facing this direction. And again, draw lightly. If you don't like a line, just erase it. You can just get rid of that sucker if you're drawing light enough, you know? You can make this look how you want it to look. Okay, so we have his basic shape down. But anyway, so I would sit in the magazine aisle while my mom was shopping at the local, it was called Food Fresh, was the store. And I would read about Sonic 3. I remember I have these video game magazines still somewhere. And I wanted to read I guess I knew how to read. Let's see, because I was seven. But I remember really investing in reading because I want to know about the new Sonic. So I have stacks of video game magazines. I collected them for a long time. So I went back up here. I kind of changed the circle. I made it a little bit, it's a little bit taller than it is wide. Something to think about. So what we're going to add here is a couple of details before we do the final thing. And again, this first part where we're doing the sketching, this takes the longest. Okay, this takes longer than the final part. So you guys, hopefully you're still with me. You're still drawn with me. We're going to add Sonic's quills. Sonic's quills, that's things on the back of his head. If you look at a real hedgehog, they don't have quills like that. But they're basically triangle shapes. I'm going to kind of change, adjust his head. I'm going to make it a little bit taller than it is wide. So there's a few triangles that come off of Sonic's head. The first triangle is kind of shaped like this with a little rounded edge. And this is his ear on the back of his head. Okay. The other one is pretty much a standard triangle, just like that. And it has another triangle on the inside. So again, triangle over here, a little bit bent. Triangle here. That's two triangles within each other, okay? Then you have these really bent triangles. I'm trying to think what these look like. But his quills basically come back. This is maybe gonna be the hardest part for you guys, because these are long lines here. But he has, they're slightly rounded, but you can make them as sharp as you want. Comes back, so this is the top one. You're gonna do three. So you wanna be really careful that you can fit all three of them in there. Let's think of some reference. So I guess the first quill comes to the base of his ear, somewhere in this area. Okay, so wherever you put his ear, that's gonna be the base of his quill. The second one will start at the base of that ear, okay? So it comes down like this. We'll say that it should land somewhere by his index finger here. And I'm going to draw through his hand, but this technically his quills are in the back. The other one is going to be going through his hand. I'm going to touch his ring finger here, and I'm going to go back up to the bottom of this triangle. Okay? So, Kelly, the body, basically, Sonic is two circles. He's a big circle, he's a little circle, and then he's got noodles coming off of him. He has noodly arms, another noodly arm, noodly legs, and then he has candy corn feet, and you can think of like a basic circle for the hands. So that's I don't know how to explain it. So when I used to draw Sonic, I actually would start with his nose, and I would just draw it from there, and I would not draw lightly. I can draw Sonic. I can tag Sonic. I'm gonna show you this really quick while people kind of catch up. I mean, I can draw Sonic really, really fast because I've drawn him since I was a little kid. You draw a circle, and so this is kind of what his face is gonna be like. And he draws eye, eyebrows, quills go backwards, ears. You know, I can draw a really quick one, but we're doing a fancy one. Okay, so we're gonna put this face onto this sphere. Okay, I don't know if that makes sense. Oh, I left off a quill. Sonic also has one quill on the back of his body. Also, this one can start. It doesn't go actually down here. He actually has a little tail. Let's do his tail. His tail is like a reverse. So these triangles are aiming this way. This one kind of curls up, actually. Okay, so it's going this direction. And then it curves out, and you actually won't even be able to see his other quill, but he has a quill here behind his hand. So it's kind of just like this weird triangle that comes off the back. Now, this hand probably is messy, so you want to go back here and make sure that it's ahead of all the quill lines. Just go through and erase all the lines on the hand that you don't want, that you're not going to be drawing, okay? So that it's cleaned up. It's just like a math problem. I'm sure you guys have heard this as you're doing homeschool, but if your columns get all messed up, you know, you lose your place. It's the same thing with art, is you want to have pretty neat lines before you start inking. Is there any other questions or anything? Sonic 3. That's why he's got 3. That game actually sold more. No. I think it sold more than Mario World in America. And that was a big deal. That showed Sega had, like, defeated Nintendo. It was a big deal. But now, Sega doesn't even make video game consoles anymore. They made the Sega Dreamcast 99. They stopped. And now they make games only, but they've never really been able to make a good Sonic game. Maybe you guys play Sonic games, but not as good as the ones from Sega Genesis era. I'm gonna erase a little bit on his belly. Okay, this is also gonna be tricky, is his face. So right about this cross, so I have this this cross line here. I'm gonna draw another circle for his nose. Now his nose is aiming down in the official art. I'm gonna have it aiming up. So you just basically, hopefully you have this cross line here and it's very light. But where this line and this line intersect, you kind of will draw a nose, okay? And I'm gonna draw it like this shape. It's kind of like a messed up oval, is the idea. And then it has a little circle. This little circle I'm drawing is the shiny mark. So if the sun was hitting Sonic's nose, that part would be shiny. And Sonic has lots of shiny marks on him. Then you'll draw, come down across, before you get to his finger. So like a space from his finger right here. We're gonna draw kind of it looks like a hot dog, I guess. Like a fat hot dog. And it comes back to the nose. So you can think maybe even a hot dog bun. The basic shape here is, or maybe a long jelly bean kind of shape. You're just drawing that, and it should fall along this line here. Does anybody have any questions? I want to make sure. I mean, Kelly had... Did I answer your question, Kelly, on how to draw the body? Or how to start the body? I mean, you have circles. I guess we're good. You guys are with me. Feel free to leave comments, though. I'll look at them. Now his eyes, the weird thing about Sonic's eyes is he doesn't have two separate eyes. He just has one eye with two pupils in it. And I don't know where they got this idea from. Felix the cat, his eyes touch down to his nose, but Sonic doesn't. So you want to go up. If you have this line here, you want to go up from his nose to about there. And you just draw an upside down U here. And from this point, you're going to draw an eye going this way and an eye going this way. And you need to think, as you're drawing this, that this is like a basketball. It's a sphere, right? And you're going to be drawing his eye like it's laid across the basketball. That's kind of the idea. So, but maybe even more simply, is you're just doing like a kind of a backward C shape. So it goes up here. It doesn't touch his ear. In fact, it doesn't even get that close to his ear. And it just looks like that. It's kind of like an upside down U. I'm going to bring his eyebrow a little bit. I actually maybe didn't go up high enough. On the original drawing, it's actually a little bit narrower. So I'm going to kind of fix that. And again, if you draw lightly, you can erase it. For those of you little kids, if you guys are not drawn lightly, you just want to kind of do your best. And then this actually kind of comes in. It matters how angry you want Sonic to be. I'm going to have a little bit angrier Sonic. So I kind of bent it in. I bent this line in. If it was out, it would make him look happier. Okay, but I like a Sonic with an attitude. So this is Attitude Sonic. This one's the same. It's same kind of idea, but this side of the eye. But it's going to be narrower. Okay, so you come around this way. It's gonna really peak right here and then just kind of come down the other side of your circle, okay? Now, Sonic in this art that I'm looking at right here, this guy, he's looking at the audience. If you wanted Sonic to be looking forward, his eye pupil would be right here and here. So if he was running, you might have that. But he's looking at the audience and being like, "What's up, Sonic 3, check out my hand, it's coming out." And so you draw his eyes more to this side, and his eyes are just an oval shape, a perfect oval shape. By the way, I wanted to say, the drawings from last week were so awesome. All you guys did such a good job on those drawings. I couldn't believe it. It made me so happy to see, like, your artwork after that. I felt really, like, whoa, that is so cool that they were able to do that. I was really proud of all of you. So I just wanted to say that. I'm looking forward to your Sonic. So I did the oval with a shiny mark on the side. This eye is actually gonna kind of overlap the eyebrow here, this oval. Make sure to draw really lightly. And then erase the top part. I gotta shut my door, 1 second. Okay, so we have Sonic is coming together. Yeah, I am going to post this, Ellen. Actually, what I'm going to start doing is, you'll notice the orientation's different. I did it horizontal. I'm going to post it on YouTube, so it's all like one video, and I might, and then I'm just going to have it on my YouTube channel, so people can watch it publicly and stuff like that. They won't be able to see the chats, obviously, and they'll hear me talking to you guys, but that's fine. Okay, so the last thing is his mouth. His mouth is way on the side of his face. If you look at Sonic, I actually sculpted Sonic with Liam. This is my sculpture of Sonic that we did. His mouth's on the side of his face. It would make sense that Sonic's mouth would be here. I don't know if you guys can see this very well. Maybe I'll scoot over a little bit. Sorry, I realize I'm kind of off center, aren't I? Yeah, let me get over here. I'm sorry, I didn't realize I was so far over. But so we're drawing Sonic from like that perspective. His mouth's on the side, so that's how he looks. This Sonic also, you can see his quills. He has 7 quills on the back. This one fell off in our trip. But these are kind of the basic shapes you're working with here, right? So his mouth is gonna be on the side. They even do this for 3D Sonic. His mouth is just over here. This again is following Felix the Cat. They literally stole the design for Sonic from Felix the Cat. For Sonic. Originally, Sonic, the Japanese, when they made him, he was a rocker. And he had this, like, Madonna girl, and they traveled and did rock tours. That was Sonic the Hedgehog. And then they brought to America, and the CEO of Mattel, that made Barbie dolls, actually. He oversaw the creation of Barbie, was offered the position of CEO of Sega of America to defeat Nintendo. And they brought Sonic over, and he said, none of this is going to work. We're just going to base his design off Felix the Cat, because it's a safe bet. But we're going to give him an attitude like the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That's literally what he said. And they made the Sonic that we all know and love. Couple things before we do the final lines here, the darker lines, is you want to have a shiny mark on a shoe and a shiny mark on this shoe, kind of just towards the top. Doesn't have to be perfect, but you'll leave this part white if you color it, and it makes it look shiny. That's kind of the idea. We're going to also add details to the gloves. So Sonic's arm, like, goes into this cup shape. Okay, so I'm drawing like a weird C here. And then his glove comes around, and it has one bump and two bumps on this cup shape that you drew over here, okay? So it's got two bumps on the gloves. And then his hand kind of follows the shape of this circle, but you actually come in from the circle and you draw just like kind of a little line like that. And another line coming this way. And so this is his the front of his knuckles, like that. And the back of his fingers come over on to this side. And you can kind of just draw a little finger there as best you can. Doesn't have to be super detailed, though, here. It's basically just, you're just adding, like, fingers behind his hand there. Okay? There we go. What are we missing? So we got his ear. I'm going to make his ear a little bit bigger, the inside triangle, but if you let, it's fine to leave it that way. This is my own preference. You can go through and start cleaning up lines you don't need. I left off his eyebrows. right in between his ear and his eye, he has a line that follows the shape of his eye. And this is his eyebrow. Okay, and then on this side, this is kind of weird, his eyebrow is popping out of his eye. Like, what is the... You can think of this as like, is bulging out of the sphere of his head, his eyebrow here, okay? This side actually comes out and it overlaps the circle like this. And then the circle comes this way. So let me clean this up a little bit so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. You can erase these lines here. You can erase this line in the middle of his eye. You can erase this line on his hot dog mouth thing. And then you can kind of make things look the way you want. Put your own little twist on it. It doesn't have to look exact. The fun thing with Sonic is he has been redesigned like 4 trillion times. There's so many different Sonics. If we look over here, you have classic Sonic. You have the Sonic now is more lankier. He doesn't have a sphere for a body. He doesn't have his noodly of arms. They're thicker. You have this weird anime Sonic. There's all different types. There's a Sonic that's new that wears like a scarf or something. He's been redesigned way too many times. So you can do your own twist on Sonic, because that's what Sega has done with the guy, with the blue hedgehog. I personally like the classic Sonic. He's the best Sonic, so there. The other thing is the socks. They're just like his glove over here. You take the cup. You draw his noodly leg going into the cup. You draw 2 bulges. Okay? Just like that. Same with this one. Going inside of the cup. 2 bulges. Just like that. So the idea is, like, I guess that his sock is folded up. Like it's bunched up, you know? But, I don't know, it always has 2 bumps, no matter what direction. It's not like this a regular sock. Like, I don't know what kind of socks these are. Did you guys watch the Sonic movie? Did you guys like the Sonic movie? I watched the Sonic movie in a theater in the Netherlands. And it was really cool. The theater. Sonic, I mean, I'm kind of old school, so it was hard for me to really... I mean, actually, I thought it was fine. It was a fun movie with the kids. I liked it. But I'm pretty hardcore into my Sonic. I've enjoyed Sonic since I was a child, and so there was nothing they could have made that would have met my expectations. Oh, the Sonic's up top. Sorry, yeah, you're right. Let me pull him down here. Yeah, sorry about that. This is a classic Sonic. This is a more modern Sonic, actually. This pose of Sonic getting ready to charge, if you guys want to come back and revisit this, and you want to take these shapes, this would be more for advanced drawers, okay? His body is facing this way, his face is facing this way, his noodly arms coming up here. This actually makes no sense, this would be behind his quills. This arm's coming around, you got lots of cool shapes. So if you're a more advanced artist, I'd recommend experimenting with different poses. You also could do Sonic running is obviously fun. Sonic's feet, when he runs fast enough, they turn into wheels. I don't even have an example of this. Oh, kind of here. Gosh, it's probably hard to see, but his feet just don't exist anymore. It's like if you guys have watched Roadrunner cartoons or whatever, his feet just sort of turn into noodles. It's weird. Usually a circle. They just kind of turn into like a circle shape, or they turn into, if he goes really fast, they turn into a figure eight shape. So I'm going to draw slightly at the bottom, but when he's running kind of fast, it's just a circle. And when he's running really fast, they do that shape. So. Okay, so we pretty much have Sonic. When I'm looking at this, I think it looks good to me. How I did it here, I would have maybe made his hand a little bit bigger. I guess I could do that, but it looks fine. And I'm gonna keep it. So at this point, if you only have pencils, what you're gonna do is erase the lines you don't want and darken the lines you want to keep. That's the main idea. And, if you are using a pen, then right at this point, you should probably get out the pen. And we're gonna just ink this. Last time I used a pen, I didn't really care for, and then it ended up bleeding into my art. I wasn't super happy with how that worked. I use these Micron pens, for those of you that are new. If you go to Michaels is constantly offering sales, especially right now during this coronavirus situation. But you can buy a package of Micron pens, and I think you can get the manga package, and they're something like, I think they're like $15 maybe for the whole package. But if you just buy one, you can buy a 0.35. The thing you want to be careful with is if you have little kids, this may not be a good idea. These are permanent. And also, if you push really hard on the end nib, it will ruin it. So you got to be careful with that. Okay, I'm going to add the lines here. When you're adding lines, when you're sketching, you're doing these short sort of lines. Let me explain this. You're doing these short sort of lines when you're sketching with a pencil, maybe. Okay. With the Micron pen, it's actually better, I'll just draw it down below. It's better if you are going across in one motion. And this might mean making yourself more comfortable. So you're just going across like that. That's a really bad line. I actually am not seated very well. I'm gonna move my camera a bit, sorry. So I'm being more comfortable. But you're doing a smooth line. That you can also ghost lines, it's called. So when you're drawing a really long line, say like when you do his quills, you might go over the top and practice before you lay down the final line. So you'll go like from point here to here, and you're gonna draw an arch. You might go like this and then do the final line really quick. But otherwise, if you're just doing sketching with the pens, that's fine, and you're practicing. It actually is like seriously like, yeah, Walmart has them too, that's right. These pens, if you go to their section. Yeah. The only reason I say go to Michael's because they always offer sales right now. They literally have, if you sign up, you can get like a 40% off. So then you were able to get the pens. Okay. Are you using them now with your kids? So it looks like not a lot of you have watched Sonic. It's fun. It's a fun movie with kids. It's good. Sure. Sorry, I'm checking my... I want to make sure I'm in. Okay, I'm not in. Let me adjust my camera here. Because I need to lift it up to get some good lines. And if you need to move around, that's totally fine. I'm going to do some smaller lines. So smaller lines, like say his eyebrow, you should... Don't think about this too much because it will ruin your drawing. But you're mostly using your wrist when you're doing these. The wrist makes motions like this, right? But you are making these smaller lines. When you make bigger lines, I'm still using my wrist, but you might start using your elbow and moving your elbow across the line. When you get really advanced, you might use your shoulder, but honestly, we're not used to using elbows and shoulders when we draw, because when we write, we only use our wrist, because you're making small motions. So your wrist is always really strong. Everybody has to write, unless you type a lot, I guess. But our elbows and our shoulders are not. So you'll notice I left this part white. This is a shiny mark, okay? Your lines may not follow exactly your pencil lines, but that's fine. Just kind of fill it in. If you're just using pencil, you don't have a marker, say, for example. This is the point. So, like, all this stuff, you'd just be doing with pencil and just doing it harder than you did before. But I really do recommend if you want to do this kind of style of artwork, this sort of comic-y video game art sort of style, you want to have Micron pens. As I said last week, Micron pens are used by professionals. Actual comic book artists use this. Sharpies are also fine, honestly. So at this point, you're kind of cleaning up maybe some of your lines, picking the lines you really want. Do his mouth here. And then you got this triangle. If you're coming in late, I saw somebody joined. We're pretty far along now, but I'm going to post this video on YouTube so that people can watch it later, and I'll probably make it more public. You guys are part of the exclusive group where we can post our drawings and get feedback. I know it's scary to post drawings. Like, I saw there's always the self-deprecating artist. Artists, they always think, well, maybe that's not true, but I know I do this. I always think my art is not good enough. And it just kind of comes with, you always think you can do better or whatever. But, and that's important in that it motivates you to draw better. But you also don't want to get to the point where you are so down on yourself that you stop drawing. Because the bottom line is that you should love drawing it. This should not be a chore. There's obviously, if you become a professional artist, there's times where you'll have to work really hard, but the main point is you're having fun, you know? The bottom line is that you should be having fun while you're drawing, and if you're not, you should rethink why you're doing it. Oh my goodness, I just realized I didn't eat lunch today. I just got really hungry. These lines here, you'll notice I'm doing some of these shorter lines. This uses, like I said, a lot of wrist. I'm actually doing a class right now, and it's free. For those of you that are interested, it's called drawabox.com. And if you want to really invest more time than just this and draw more, it's really good. It kind of shows you how to... It shows you how to draw and gives you some of the basic techniques like anatomy, how to draw good lines, and that kind of stuff. But for now, we're just having fun drawing. His tail technically comes off the back there. You can draw a line through it or not. It actually is, it's not a big deal. I mean, Sonic, yeah, I mean, see, you could draw this circle, but I'm not going to. Up here, I'm going to draw his... You can't see his quill on the back of it, on his back. I don't like how I did this leg. I'm going to kind of straighten this leg out a bit. So yeah, you want to think of these in three dimensions. These are like straws, like Lynx last week. These come into the socks here. The noodles come in. You can draw, so technically because his leg's coming into this sock, which is a weird sock, you think he'd wear like athletic socks that are stuck to his like legs. This would actually have some black down in there. So it would be a shadow down in there. I'm using a 0.35 millimeter pen. These are called fine liners. As I said, micron is good. These are, this one gives a pretty, fine line, but you also can thicken stuff up. Like, so for example, let's see, the light source for Sonic, I'll just draw it on here actually, is coming this way. It's coming down this way. This means his body here would create a shadow on his leg, and you would fill this in with black. You guys don't have to do this part. But I'm gonna add a lot of black so you can kind of see how shadows work. Lines that are away from the sun would be, or the light, sorry, would be thicker. So this line, actually I might go over it again and kind of thicken it up. Lines that are over on this side closer to the light would be thinner. Underneath his head, this also would be all black. Now you guys don't all have to do this. Don't do the shadows. But you, if you're using pens, you might consider it. Because at first it's going to be weird. You're going to be like, wait, I'm drawing a random thick black line. But this would be totally, this is kind of a comic book idea to show how dark it is. So it looks kind of weird, but this would be dark. It probably would even kind of bend because it's a sphere. It'd kind of bend like that a little bit. This arm also would probably have, like, you want to make sure you get the shape, right? And it would be black because it's behind his head. So it looks kind of weird, but when you add the colors, it'll look cool. The bottom of his tail would also be thicker. You can thicken up that line. Under his glove, maybe we can thicken that up. It's kind of optional. And probably under his hand would cast a shadow onto his glove, so you'd thicken that up. Under his fingers, there'd be no light under his fingers. Might thicken this line up, and I'll kind of go through. But let's finish these lines first. So, this is a pretty straight line here. So you want to make sure you move your paper around so that you're comfortable. So I'm going to pull downwards, and I might ghost this line a few times and go like that. So I got a nice straight line with your pen. If you're uncomfortable with that, you can do the sketchy kind of this action. But for the most part, I'm pulling this straight down. Now when I go up, I'm weaker going up. So I can move this around, but I'm totally fine, say, pulling to this side. Okay, most people are pretty strong when they pull to this side. So I ghost it a couple times to get an idea what direction I'm gonna go, and then I go there, okay? Same with this line. Well, this line's easy. This is a wrist, I'm using my wrist there. This one, I'm gonna ghost it a couple times, and then I'm gonna go for it. You want to be fairly fast and bold in your lines. You don't want to overthink it. If you overthink it, they'll be shaky. You'll have like this kind of action going on. And those kind of lines, to people that are looking at your artwork, if they see shaky lines, I don't mean to freak you out with this, but if they see shaky lines in the back of their brain, they can notice it, and they notice that it doesn't look as sturdy as it should be. Gives the sense, this wobbly line gives a sense of unease, okay? So if you draw a box and you're drawing like kind of weak lines, it gives you a feeling like this box is like a ghost or something, right? But if you draw thicker lines, oh, even that isn't, or more straight lines, this bottom one is actually a bad example, but you draw these thick lines, it makes the box look more sturdy. And so you want to make sure your lines actually do communicate something when you're drawing. I'm gonna draw a little line on the top here. It just kind of gives you a sense of like, and I'm not gonna do these shiny marks. I'm actually gonna draw this in with red. So I'll put the shiny marks with the red. So if you did that already though, that's okay. It's totally fine. Link was the best, Kelly. Is that what you said? Yeah, I was just saying, I don't know if you're in here, but I was so impressed with everybody's drawings. I was like, dude, you're so good. Shigeru Miyamoto, he made all of the Nintendo characters. I'm gonna add some shadows in here, too. Yuji Naka is the guy who made Sonic the Hedgehog. He was actually a programmer. Shigeru Miyamoto was a programmer, too, but Shigeru Miyamoto knew how to market a character. Yuji Naka did not. But what he made was a way for the old video games to scroll really, really, really fast. And they said, if we made a game that moved at this speed, it would totally defeat Mario. And he came up with it. So he was very smart. But he didn't have a lot of say in Sonic. Well, he knew Sonic. I think he made Sonic as a Hedgehog, I'm pretty sure. But as far as the Sonic we're drawing right now, he didn't have a lot of say in what Sonic looked like. But he did have a lot of say in how the game felt. And how the game felt was like it was a really fast pinball game. That was the idea. There would be a shadow here from his stomach. I'm gonna draw that in here. Some of these shadows might feel weird at first, but when you get them all in there, it should look pretty good. I'm gonna draw a shadow inside of his glove, just some lines kind of in there. This line would be thickened up. This is really far away from the light source. The side of the gloves far away from the light source. This finger would be pretty dark too, because it's behind the hand and it's far away from the light source. Is that Gracie or Kelly that's on there? I can never tell. I know that. So we got Gabe and we got Zeke as they're playing as their parents, but it's hard for me to know who's who. His tail here, I didn't make a good enough point. Gosh, that's not so good. Okay, now I saved the hardest part for last, so make sure you're... Oh, and sorry, I forgot this part. It's good to take a break and look at your art, see how it's coming along. Sometimes you get really narrow focused. If you're just looking at it for a long time, you forget what the heck is you're doing. But I'm gonna do this hard part, which is the quill. Whew. You wanna get really comfortable for this quill. It's gonna come up like that. And you wanna do it ideally in a bold line. But if not, you can kinda take your time with it and do a little bit at a time. Now, these lines are not too difficult. You can actually use your wrist just fine. This one's kind of weird, but this one there. And then this line. So his ear, this ear back here, does not have a... does not have a triangle in it because it's facing the opposite direction of this ear. So that's why. So far I'm actually pretty happy with how this turned out. I'm happier with it than the Link one that I did. I felt like my Link one was kind of, was okay, but I was pretty nervous actually when I was doing this last week, to be honest with you. You might notice some lines. If you made a mistake, like say a line goes into a place it's not supposed to. Uh-oh. No, I'm still in here. Sorry, my phone collapsed. You guys still there? Yeah. So anyway, that's it. That's it. You can add some thicker lines here, like I said, for shadows, for those of you that are doing that. That's fine. As far as colors, Sonic's color, oh, you can see that line right there. I'm gonna thicken this up because I drew his quill into the other line. You wanna avoid that. But some of you might be coloring it, and you basically, he's blue. You can look up his colors online. I don't, obviously don't have it here, but. Sorry, I lost my video here. Video's no longer available. Uh-oh. Are you guys still on this video? Can somebody just reply yes or no? Yeah, are you guys still in there? Yeah, okay, good. My phone had just kicked me off of my other phone so I couldn't see your guys' comments. And then I couldn't get back in. So anyway, thicken up some of these lines away from the sun here. This would be fairly dark on this quill in the back. You see, I'm being pretty careful. Okay, so for colors, that's what I was talking about. Also, some Sonics has another circle around his eye, and it's green. I am doing the old school Sonic, though. Basically, he's blue, his stomach and this hot dog shape here are like a yellowy shape. His socks and his gloves are white, and then his shoes are red. So he's actually, it's really easy to do Sonic. The only tricky color is this yellow. It's not exactly yellow, it's like a, it's actually like a flesh color. So sometimes it's hard to find flesh colors in the house if you don't have them already. Do your best on that. You might have a colored pencil or something that's that color, but markers are usually tricky to come by in the flesh shape. Also notice when you're adding shadows, it might go over it. Some of you are probably already ahead of me pretty far. So at this point, what I do is you want to make sure your ink is dry, and then you are going to erase these pencils marks that You want to make sure your eraser is not leaving anything. You want to make sure that your pencils, your eraser is not leaving any black marks. And then you can blow on it. Some people get serious about this and they get a hairdryer and they hair dry it. They do that with painting also. I keep seeing stuff that I want to fix on this. Never gonna let this dry. You want to make sure it's completely dry or you will smudge black ink all over. So I'm going to be really careful at first. I'm going to be erasing all the pencil lines. At this point, if you inked it, you want to erase all the pencil lines. If you use pencils, you might go through and erase a couple different lines here. But overall, you're just erasing these so that all that's left is the black ink. Some people like actually leaving the pencil lines. I think it looks cool. My friend Drew said that. He's like, hey, just leave the pencil lines on that art. I like the sort of shady, the sketchy look. That's fine. You guys can do that if you want to. So you want to be careful that it doesn't smudge up. I didn't switch my paper. I said last week I was going to switch my paper. I bought this pad was really cheap, and it's called a pen pad or whatever. And it's cheap, and it looks like it was for markers and for drawings like this. But I've just noticed the quality is not very good, and I guess you get what you pay for. I do, if you want to get really serious, you can buy a Bristol board. That's a little bit more expensive, but not that bad. Michael's, you can buy one, get one free. Or buy one, get one half off. I think it depends on the brand. Walmart also has Bristol board too, and that's what comic book artists use, is Bristol board. The reason I use this is my Bristol board is huge, and I don't think you'd be able to see it. These sheets are very small sheets, so they're good for just doing like kind of a sketch more. But the issue, like I said, there's some smudging. I can see some smudging on here. I don't like how the ink sets on it, so. Okay, so we have Sonic. If you can be done. Right now's a good time. I went over. That was about an hour. But if you want to see how to color it, or maybe you've already started, that's fine. I'm gonna add some colors to this thing, and I'm gonna be done. See here. So I'm gonna use my I'm gonna take a little bit of time to actually color this correctly, and I want to show you how to shade. So if you guys want to stay longer, totally fine, please do. I'd love, but I'm gonna do this correctly. Last time I just laid down some solid colors. But I'm gonna show you guys how to shade with colors. And if you already started coloring, did your thing, that's fine too. But let's see, I didn't get my colors ready before I started. So let me grab them here. I'm gonna get this. And let's see, I need red. I need a red color. Sorry, one sec. And then maybe a light gray. To add shadows and colors, you might use light gray. When it's white, so like on the gloves, if you want to add some shading, you can use light gray color. Let's see. So it's always good to have scratch paper on the side here, so you can test out stuff. I want to make sure that I have a good blue for Sonic. That's what most of the color is. Okay, so I have a lighter blue and a darker blue, so I can show how lighting works. So, I don't have the lighting exactly, but I'm going to kind of show you is that the lighting, if you were going to do some highlights, you might add a lighter blue along the back of his quill here, okay? This is towards your light source. So again, our light source is up here. So I am doing a nice light blue right there. I would even do maybe a little bit on his tail. and maybe on his leg also. It's good to start with the light color because you can actually use the darker color after. And you can go over the light color and you typically won't even see it. Make this a little bit thicker of a line. These nibs on these chameleon markers are kind of fat. So when you're doing something small like this, it's hard to get exactly what you want. Oh, the ear also. You probably have some highlight going on in the ear. So I would just go on the top. And then on this ear also would probably have something in this neighborhood here. I'm just going to do that. And then I'm going to show you. So then I get my darker blue. This is just standard blue. Like, I'm sure there's an exact color. I'm just using a totally standard blue color. Okay. Ooh, that's kind of a violet. I'm gonna go with it. It's not blue. It's a royal blue, actually. Just has some purpley colors in it. Oops, I just realized. Add some highlights on his eyebrow also. So his eyebrow, like I said, is sticking out, so there would be like a highlight mark right along here, maybe a little bit on that. So I add these, and this just shows where the sun is going to hit it, and the color, just like the thick black lines, the color would also brighten up. But if you guys want to just do thick, you're just doing colors, you're not, you just kind of want to add the colors down quick, just pick one color of blue and just go for it, okay? Yeah. Actually, before I started this video, I didn't actually pick the colors out. I might have taken a little bit more time, but these ones are fine, I think. Sonic is, I've seen him in a variety of different colors. This blue is on the darker side, I think, the one I'm using here, but that's fine. I'm not going to do this in this video because I'm going to kind of, I'm going to finish coloring and be done, but you also, if you're using pens, you might need to go, after you color, you might need to go back over, might need to go back over your black lines, clean up any mistakes to do with coloring. Like, see, I kind of went into his eyeball a little bit. I never was very good at coloring, to be totally honest with you. These markers I'm using also, for those of you that are new, these are Prismacolor markers. They're pretty expensive, actually. All these alcohol-based markers are expensive, is the bottom line, but you can also use just Sharpies or fine for starting out, but if you're a little kid, I don't know if your parents are going to let you use Sharpies, because they are permanent. So you can just start off with Crayola markers or fine, honestly, and just get an idea of whatever you're comfortable with. Everybody uses a different sort of medium, you know? You can use colored pencils, pastels, whatever you want to do. Yeah, such good art last week. I'm excited to see your Sonics. Make sure to post them in the club. The Drawing with Mr. Dale About Facebook group. And I just want to see what you guys drew. So you'll see as I'm getting in this blue more, and you see the highlight, it kind of gives this effect of just light is just slightly hitting the certain parts of Sonic. And it adds a lot of depth to the drawing. If you get really into coloring, and you take a lot of time to plan it out, it can really make your art look professional. Probably more than anything. An average person, if you do coloring right, they're going to be super impressed. Like, oh my gosh, it looks like the real thing. So, and I actually, to be totally honest with you, I didn't own any good coloring stuff when I was a kid. I didn't like coloring. So I actually have been really learning how to do it, I would say, in the last, oh gosh, 2-3 years. My niece Ruby, who drew with us last time, she's not here today, but she started getting into the coloring, and then she just has an eye for it. And if you look at her link that she drew, it was really impressive. She changed the colors. She didn't like Link's colors because he's like lime green and stuff. So she drew him with purple and green, and it looks really good. She said,
"What does it say? The boys will like this one."
Yeah, Stan, no problem, man. I'm gonna post this. I'm gonna post this on YouTube, and I'll post it in the group also, and just post it generally on my Facebook, so you'll be able to see it. But anyway, yeah, Ruby has an eye for color that I do not have. I can never tell like what colors go together well. It's just not my thing. I think one of you texted me. Sorry, one sec. Zeke won't let Becky comment on the iPad. Sorry, that's funny. Okay, so, yeah. Coloring. If you leave your pencil marks, also it can kind of muddy up your coloring. So you want to be careful with that. When you have a line like this, you want to try to keep it as straight as possible. Maybe on the back? Actually, I'm going to leave this dark. But there might even be a little highlight on the back of his leg here, but I'm just gonna leave it. Okay, so my coloring is a little bit uneven on some parts, but it's okay. I might also take a little bit more time to pick the colors, but it is what it is. So that's all the blue on this guy for the flesh color. I need another flesh color. Sorry, one sec. So, flesh color, I'm gonna add just a little bit of a highlight, here. On the back of his hot dog thing, here. You can keep it pretty loose. I always feel kind of some pressure when you guys are watching to do this. Like, it ends up changing my drawing a little bit. I feel like I have to show certain things. So I may not have drawn it this way before, but whatevs. Oh my gosh, it's 2:15 already? Okay, this tip has a lot of black, and one sec. Ooh, yeah, good thing I did that. Sometimes you need to wipe a little bit of it off just to make sure it doesn't ruin your drawing. So yeah, it's kind of an orangey, flesh-tony color. I'm being super careful not to pick up any of the black. If you're working with just standard, standard, like, copy paper, you might have an issue where there's some bleeding going on. I also noticed that, gosh, I didn't erase his mouth very well. I'm gonna try to do this really carefully. Don't wanna get any of that pencil residue into your marker. Those will make it look like mud. That also doesn't help, like I said, this paper. I don't know why I keep using this paper. It's because I bought it and I need to go through all of it. I'm going to kind of put a little bit on the top here, just to give it, it makes it look three-dimensional a little bit. If you have kind of the highlight running a little bit south of the dark black line. And then his arm, get that in there. Sometimes artists also will use like more like three colors. So if you're using three colors, you might have a standard color like this color. And then you go one tone darker, one tone lighter. And so the lighter would be closer to the sun. His belly, obviously. and the darker, you know, you have a darker shade that's farther away from the light source. These markers too, the alcohol-based, you can, this also, this pad is not designed for alcohol-based markers, it's designed for pens. So this doesn't take to it very well. In fact, if I flip this thing over, you can see it really bleeds through. If you have Bristol board, it doesn't bleed through. That's the nifty part of Bristol board. It's a very sturdy, thick paper that can hold a lot of ink. And you might get out your you know, this is called blending. What did I do with my marker? What the heck? You might want to blend it in a little bit. So you go back over this and you can kind of make it look a little bit more natural. You can do that also with the blues. If you go back and get your original light blue here, you might go back over it and it makes it look a little bit, ooh gosh, I went way too high up on that. Makes it look a little bit more natural if you just go over it. So anyway, so if I was gonna ink, I might go over this with a thicker black line on the top to cover up that mistake there, where I bled out of the line. Okay, then red. I need a light red, actually. Let's see. Ew, that is orange. Yuck. Let's see. It might even be like kind of a pink if you're gonna do a highlight. That's fine. I'm gonna use this just off the top of my head here. I have access to a lot of different colors. I know not everybody has that, but it's kind of, yeah. I just want that little highlight there. Yeah, cool. Yeah, finish up the YouTube. If you need to go, I totally understand. As usual, I'm going over time. I need to just basically say this is going to take about an hour and 15 minutes and just commit to that. I have to go somewhere actually at 3, so. Look forward to seeing the posts. I want to see what you guys draw. Gabe, I hope you've been drawing superheroes, dude. I really like what your superhero drawings are so good. And you're keeping up on that. Not a lot of superhero movies lately. Is there any you remember superhero movies? Seemed like we had like 400 superhero movies, and then after Avengers, it's just been silent, you know? Isn't that weird? I know they're coming out. I'm not super stoked for the next phase, I guess. I feel like Avengers Endgame was kind of the climax of that whole situation. It's like, that's just the endgame, literally. But, I don't know. Yeah, here, this shoe would be darker. Like, so if I had a darker red, I might come on the bottom and make it like a darker red color. The top wouldn't actually be lit too much. Oh, shoot, I left off the shiny mark, sorry. Yeah, shoot. I would have left a little spot here for a shiny mark, and also maybe on that side. Gosh, you know, I'm gonna show you this with whiteout. You should really avoid using whiteout in your artwork. But I just wanna illustrate this whole shiny mark business to y'all. So Sonic just has like I use this as an acrylic paint. And if you do make a mistake, it works pretty well. So I might just add like a nice shiny mark right there. And then maybe a shiny mark here. And you don't, this'll dry. But, yeah, it'll dry and look cool. But you can see it gives kind of a dimensionality to the drawing. So, yeah. Okay, that's pretty much it. The only thing I would add is, I guess on the white, you could add some shading. So say if you have a gray marker, you could add some shading away from the sun there, and that will make it look cool. You can add it behind his finger, it'd be a little bit darker. This would be really dark down here. Back here would be dark. Actually, this whole hand would actually be gray. For the most part, probably. And then Put it back here. Oh, I forgot his ear. We left off his ear. The ear would just be a dark flesh color inside of here. In fact, it might be a little bit darker. But there you go. That's my Sonic. I'm pretty happy with it. It turned out pretty good. I'm going to use the better paper next time. I'm just going to go buy some whatever it's called. Forgot his shoe highlights here. I'm going to buy some bristle board and do that next time so I don't have this muddy effect. I really don't like the mud. I drew on the sides, and that kind of ruins your drawing a little bit, but whatever. It's for teaching purposes. Do a little bit of gray inside of his sock. If I have a darker gray, I might even touch this up a bit. So you get kind of this gradual thing going on. You can see how the color really adds some depth to it. It makes it look cooler when you do a good color job. Yeah, again, if you want to keep working on this, you can go back over your lines with black and kind of clean things up. That's what I would do if I kept working on this. But other than that, it's done. Make sure to post your drawings on the Facebook group. I'd love to see them. And And I hope you guys have a good day. It's super nice outside. And I hope you guys are doing okay during the coronavirus thing. This is just wearing on me. I'm done. Like, I know we got to do what we're we're obligated to obviously do something and help people out. And but I just personally want to go back to normal, and I think all of us are in that boat, you know. But this is how things are. But hey, guys, thanks for drawing with me, and I hope next week we can meet up again, draw something. Please, if you guys have ideas of what you want to draw, you need to let me know. I would be happy, like Gabe, if you're still on there, if you have something like a superhero or something, just send it to me. Maybe we could do that. Just let me know. If you guys have something you want to learn how to draw, I think somebody recommended Zygarde, I remember, the Pokemon. I'd draw a Pokemon, as I call them, to my kids. It drives them nuts. And that might get Liam, my son, to actually draw with me also. he drew Link last time, but so maybe get him in if we do Pokemon. He would like to hang out with Gabe and Zeke online. That'd be fun. That's all I got to say. So thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day.